Education stakeholders in the Philippines are calling on schools to make their curricula more future-ready. That's why institutions such as Mapua University are aiming to raise the bar on AI-integrated education in the country.
To discuss with us how AI learning is changing the game for Filipino learners, we have with us Rick Shangro, the president of Sintana Education, and Dr. Bonifacio Doma Jr., the EVP of Academic Affairs at Mapua University. Bonnie.
Hello.
Rick, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You know, just yesterday, we had the Queen of Geeks here. she was talking about improving the curriculum for education in public schools and maybe most all private schools so that we can create a workforce that is AI ready. And in that interview, she was saying there are courses already, but she did not realize that Mapua already has something world-class integrating AI into the curriculum in Mapua. Tell us more about that.
So last May 2022, Mapua University partnered with Arizona State University through Sintana Education. And because of this partnership, we're able to have access to the repository of Arizona State University, the whole online repository of Arizona State University. Now, I think last year, OpenAI, the largest, you know, the creator of ChatGPT, partnered with Arizona State University. And because of this, there are already courses provided to Mapua students in prompt engineering, in scripting, in ChatGPT via Python, using Python, and AI Foundation. So because of these courses, we're able to provide students their future needs in order to face this you know, impactful AI tool that is ChatGPT. So we're actually starting to incorporate ChatGPT in our courses in Mapua University.
In your courses and in the teaching of the teachers?
You have courses to view it as an assistive tool, and it will find ways in different courses, in different programs. Of course, this is a preliminary time, and so more and more faculty members will adapt how this ChatGPT can be incorporated to achieve learning outcomes and to make the workflow different and more efficient, more adaptive, more personalized in the future.
Now Rick, we know about Mapua University, but please do tell us more about what Sintana is and what will it be bringing into this partnership, aside from that direct access to the repository of ASU.
Yeah, sure, Ron. So Sintana Education is Arizona State University's global implementation partner. So when Arizona State University wants to work overseas, they call on us to give them a hand. Okay. We have locations all over the globe, and we work with ASU. One of the reasons we work with ASU, it's one of the most innovative universities in the United States, ranked number one for 9 years by U.S. News World Report. And so it's a university that's always on the cutting edge of whatever's happening. And in this case, it's on the cutting edge of artificial intelligence, which is, as a partner now with Mapua, we can begin bringing those tools and technologies, those faculty development programs, over to the Philippines with Mapua.
And you know, Rick, aside from the fact that I want to ask you about the debate on whether Ron and I will be replaced by AI or not, I think that's a great conversation. What is your assessment so far of the educational system here in the Philippines? Are we ready for this? How is Mapua going to trailblaze in this aspect?
You know, I can't talk about the whole Philippines, but I can talk about Mapua. Right, so I can talk about their readiness to be able to receive this technology. And of course, it's so new, right, that you know, you have to begin thinking about how do you train your faculty, as you just asked, you know, how do you work with your students, how do you make sure that they know how to use artificial intelligence, what are the boundaries around it, you know, is it, you know, what are things you should be worried about in using artificial intelligence, and the ethics around it, of course, you know, and the bias that sometimes it introduces into the conversation or into what you're trying to get from the AI. So I think it's really important because Mapua has decided to sort of take all those features and begin bringing it into the university and thereby help their students become better better learners and ultimately better employees for companies around the Philippines.
Doc Bonnie, I'll throw the question to you. Same question from Salve about how you view the current curriculum of education here in the Philippines. Is it enough? Does it equip students enough skills and learnings for an AI-assisted future?
I think right now the curriculum must be added with these basic tools, like for example, the artificial intelligence, at least an introductory part for Mapua. We already instituted that it's mandatory for all programs to have introduction to AI. Mm-hmm. And this is just the beginning. Of course, with all the additional courses available to us by Arizona State University, we can improve on that to prepare our graduates for the future, because right now, according to OpenAI in their last developers conference, 92% of Fortune 500 are already using ChatGPT weekly. Okay. Around 2 million developers and 100 million people per week. Mm-hmm. So this is very impactful, very consequential to the future of work. Mm-hmm. So if we do not begin now training our students to prepare for this technology, then it's actually to our disadvantage. Mm-hmm.
Just going back to the teachers now, there were courses offered to the teachers as well. I was wondering about the reception. Were there a lot who took the courses? Was it mandatory, voluntary?
Well, right now it's not mandatory. It's okay. Actually offered there for them to take. However, there will be some policies in the future that will be mandatory,
right?
Because it's not only in engineering and science and STEM programs, but ChatGPT will find its way also to social science,
right?
Architecture, media studies, and so eventually it will become mandatory.
But were there a lot who signed up, and did you hear of anyone who was still hesitant on signing up on these AI-related courses? And this question is just to gauge how our Philippine educators are feeling about it and viewing an AI-assisted future.
You know, like any other technology, we're very slow to adapt in our country and maybe in this part of the world. But then, of course, after we have, gained some experience and exposure to that, I know for a fact that people will be made aware that this is very important for the students.
Yep.
And as faculty members, I think that's the primordial thing that you have to look upon. And the idea here is that this will not actually change so much, but you have to take a look at this as an assistive tool in order for you to attain outcomes.
Yep.
So at the end of the day, it's about demonstration of learning outcomes.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe similar as Rick told me, maybe this is in the 1980s, like adopting calculators. So this is just, a phase.
Ooh, scary calculator.
Yeah. So during that time, there are some faculty members that do not allow calculators.
Yeah.
But now everybody's using it, so that's a good analogy.
Yeah. So I think that's the best analogy for this one.
Rick, I'm sure to Ron's question, you have experienced this in many different countries. What were the best practices so that everybody's more friendly towards this new technology? And what were the investments that needed to be made?
Yeah, I think on best practices is a great question, because I think what happens is that people just begin using it. Right, and then they begin
out of necessity.
Sometimes out of necessity, sometimes just to experiment with it. Sometimes they've heard their friend be using it,
mm-hmm.
and so they begin experimenting with these what are called generative AI tools like ChatGPT, and I think what's important is one best practice is to provide some of the fundamental understanding and training in what these technologies can do and what they can't do,
mm-hmm.
and where they work and where they don't work. And I think that's something that Mapu is doing very well. I think to your question about sort of what do we see around the world, we see around the world what's happening here in the Philippines, all over the world. And that is this chatter about AI and what's going on and how it's going to affect jobs and how is it going to influence me and how can I benefit from it. And I think we're all going through this learning stage of the introduction of what will become a very consequential technology,
mm-hmm.
and then people trying to figure out what to do with it exactly. And And I think even that's happening in the states. You know, so in the states, we're going through that same process of trying to understand how to embrace it, how to work with it, how to put some guardrails around it so that it's used appropriately.
For good.
That's right. And also to make sure we're really understanding where that data comes from, because all of those models have an underlying set of information, right? And that underlying information, if you don't know where that comes from,
the transparency is key.
Transparency is really important, because otherwise you just end up, you know, asking questions, and before you get answers back, but you don't know the source of it. I mean, things you really worry about.
And someone could take
journalism.
Advantage of that.
And this is something in your field that you have to be clear. Where's my source? You know, is it trustworthy? Is it reliable? You know, is it appropriate? Is it current, right? Mm-hmm. And these are all things that if you don't know where that data is coming from, you're going to get results that you may not be really comfortable with.
I'm getting flashbacks of days of review of related literature.
Now you can do it, using ChatGPT.
And
spend more time in your analytical thinking and critical skills.
Frees up bandwidth in our head.
So it will free up with the manual reading of 100 articles, summarizing all of them,
we know
getting
the feeling,
even one sentence only in one 100-page book.
Yes. Mapua obviously has a lot of resources. How much was the investment in this new thing that you're doing with AI and Arizona State University and Sintana? And the reason why I'm asking that is a lot of our viewers probably are thinking of going into something similar, and they'll want to know exactly how much of resources will have to be set aside for something like this.
So with the partnership, there's actually some financial arrangement, of course, with ASU and Sintana. But then the programs under the scope of collaboration, the tuition fees are actually competitive with whatever the tuition fees of other schools. Mm-hmm. So there's a misconception that because of this partnership, it must be very expensive, you know, but it's not that way. Mm-hmm. So because there's some arrangement between Arizona State University and Mapua University, I think the main goal of Arizona State University is actually access. Because one of the main vision of Arizona State University is inclusion and access. And so by cooperating with other universities around the world through Sintana Alliance, they were able to fulfill that mission of access and inclusivity. Mm-hmm. So because of that, we were able to offer the programs under the collaboration at a very competitive cost. Okay. And affordable cost with the students.
Doc Bonnie, will you be able to tell us the courses that are being already being offered in Mapua that are AI related?
So we incorporated this to business with the health sciences and of course engineering and sciences programs in Mapua.
What specific courses can you name?
The
some?
Engineering programs, almost all engineering programs, business administration programs, some of our health sciences programs, and then I'm sure in a couple of months or next year, we are going to adapt this also to other programs in Mapua, like architecture, media studies, and other programs.
Well, as you can see, probably Ron was the type who will use the calculator first and you last one. I enjoyed this conversation very much, gentlemen. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for having us.